When I was 5 years old, I was taken away from my mother, myself, and 4 other siblings. We were put in foster homes, but we were separated.
No one told Shana Joseph why she couldn't be with her mom, or why she and her sister lived apart from their siblings.
We weren't allowed to eat at the table. We had to stand in a corner and eat bones. They didn't give us food like they gave the other children.
She took out her pain and frustration on others.
I was getting into a lot of fights, very angry. A lot of it had to do with the fact that I miss my family. We had visits to go see our family. Most of the visits, my mom never showed up. So, you know, that made me very angry. My grandmother would come, my aunt would come, but my mom wasn't there.
After 5 years, Shana and 4 of her brothers and sisters were reunited when their grandmother gained custody of them. By now, Shana had become withdrawn.
If I had toys, I played by myself. I didn't really want to be bothered with anyone. The thought of my mother, my family, was always on my mind.
Shana was smoking at 12 years old and soon joined a gang. She was always on the streets, and that's where she learned the truth about her mother.
That my mom was on drugs. Everybody on the street knew, all my friends, they knew about it. She's the reason why we were taken away. That made me angry.
At 13, Shana overdosed on pain pills.
Even at a young age, I knew this is not what I want. I have friends who, they had good families, and I was jealous of them. They had their mom, they had their dad, you know, people who cared about them. Their family would come to school to see them in the games, but nobody showed up at my games. Nobody, you know, said, hey, Shana, go ahead, you know, keep up the good grades. I'm proud of you. I never heard a I love you at all.
The next thing Shana remembers is waking up in the ER, having her stomach pumped. After she recovered and was released, she went right back to the streets. When Shana was 15, she met Marland, a member of an up-and-coming hip-hop group called Sporty Thieves. As they became serious, he started taking her to his church.
He really loved me. He was always with me, you know, and he actually was the one who introduced me to God.
Eventually, Shana got pregnant. They planned on getting married, but it would never happen. One night, Marland was walking near Shana's home when he was hit by a drunk driver. Shana ran to the scene where she discovered both legs were badly crushed.
I saw him get up on his knees and I saw the people yell, you know, get back down, get back down. He kept trying to get up. But I heard him praying and I heard him repenting of his sins and asking Jesus to forgive him and to wash him in his blood, you know, and to let him into heaven. I heard him saying, you know, protect my son. I can't forget those words as he lay there on the ground.
Paramedics arrived after what seemed an eternity and took him to the hospital.
The doctors came out and told my grandmother and told myself that he passed. And I think that was like the worst news I could ever hear because I was back to where I started, but this time I was with a baby. And to me, all the love that I was getting now was gone, completely gone.
Days later, a few women from a nearby church paid Shana a visit. They had heard about the accident and came to check on her and offer their help. They also shared with her the love of Jesus Christ and how only He could save her.
I shared with them some of my childhood and what I've been doing. She said, God can change your life. You might not be able to repent the way your boyfriend, you know, that doesn't mean you will. And that right there alone was the turning point for me where I said, I don't want to go to hell. I was in the living room and she asked me to repeat after her as she led me to the Lord, and I did. I repent of my sins, I confess and acknowledge that Jesus died on a cross for my sins.
While Shana embraced her new life as a Christian, it took time to heal from the pain and hurt.
I would cry. I don't think there was a day I didn't cry. I cry. It's times I would punch the wall, but I was angry. I was angry. My life is not turning out the way I wanted it to turn out.
Through the support of people in her church and prayer, she finally saw herself as God sees her.
I can hear him saying, it's gonna be okay. You're gonna make it. You're not gonna turn out like everybody else said you're gonna turn out. You're not gonna end up like your mother. You're gonna be able to make it. You're gonna be successful. And it was that point that that love that I thought was taken away, I felt the love that I needed. And that was the love of Jesus Christ. And he was revealing to me that I'm all the love you're looking for. I'm all the love you need.
In time, Shana was able to let go of her anger and forgive her mother. She also married Stephen, and today they have three children, Giovanni, Venice, and Marlon Jr. She's a minister at Harvest Army Church International, the same church that took her in 14 years ago. Shana and Stephen travel the world preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ.
He revealed his love to me. He revealed that this is the love you need. You know, your mom's not around, but I'm here. He revealed to me that, you know, I will take care of you. I can change your life. And all I needed to do at that moment was release everything to him. You know, not just attend church, but surrender everything to him.